CBS live from McAfee Stadium in Oakland, California. Old-fashioned AFC rivalry today. The Raiders hosting the Miami Dolphins. And welcome inside the broadcast booth, everyone. Ian Eagle along with Solomon Wilcots. Oakland Raiders are trying to get themselves into the playoff conversation in the AFC. Norv Turner last week, an emotional return to Washington. They get the win over the Redskins. They play the Dolphins today. Solomon, your keys to victory for Oakland.
I think the Raiders offense is going to have to get running with Lamont Jordan and force that eight-man front from Miami Dolphins defense. And then they can go down the field with Moss and Porter and hit home runs in the passing game. And then on defense, they're going to have to hit and harass the quarterback and create turnovers. That's the way the Oakland Raiders want to play football today.
Miami's going through some tough times now, but it was only 2 weeks ago they actually led in the fourth quarter against New England. If they got a win for Nick Saban on that day, they would have been tied for first place in the AFC East. Instead, it's gone the other way. They're 3-7. What are the big keys for them today?
Well, they want to raise the curtain with their running attack with Ronnie Brown and Ricky Williams. That is going to have to set the table. It's going to allow Gus Frerotte to be steady in the pocket and make good decisions. And then in this secondary, we know that they have to be the last line of defense against the likes of Randy Moss and Jerry Porter. They've given up 10 touchdown passes in 10 games so far this year.
Oakland has won the toss. Miami will kick it off with Olindo Mare. Deep man for the Raiders. Chris Carr, number 23. Doug Gabriel in front of him. Carr, a rookie, averaging just over 24 yards per return. Both teams dealing with injuries, and we are underway from the Bay Area. Big game for the Raiders. San Diego on the schedule next week. Here's Carr. And he comes up shy at a 30-yard line. That's where Oakland will set up shop as Bowens made the play on special teams. Kerry Collins, impressive fourth quarter showing a week ago in that victory over the Redskins. He was 9 of 12 in the final quarter for 128 yards through the air. Collins coming into this week the number 2 passer in the NFL in terms of yardage this season. He has thrown for over 2,600 yards in 2005. Double tight end set. Anderson and Flemister to open up. And Lamont Jordan, flags come down. Oakland, the most penalized team in the NFL, averaging 10 penalties per game. Here's Ron Winter.
False start. Offense number 70. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
And that's the left guard for Norv Turner's offensive line, Brad Badger. Gets caught on the first play from scrimmage. They'll back it up for the Raiders. And a first and 15 from the 22 for Oakland. Jordan, the lone setback. And they'll go to the ground game with Jordan. Unable to break any tackles as he picks up 3. Number of Miami defensive players there, including Jason Taylor for the 19th ranked defense in the NFL. Barry Sims will have his hands full with Taylor today. That's a big challenge for the left tackle, backs, and receivers. Jerry Porter is coming off a tremendous day against Washington. Porter finished with 6 catches, 142 yards, and a touchdown in that 16-13 victory. At a 2nd and 12, Collins straight back. Little flare to the outside, and Jordan breaks a tackle. Able to stay on his feet, as Taylor was there to drag him down after Pope missed initially. Pope making the play and a pickup of a yard. Taylor anchors that defensive line, and this is where the injuries are. The linebacking crew, no Zach Thomas today. Junior Seau out for the season, so the rookie Channing Crowder moves to the middle. Derek Pope getting the start, and Donnie Spragan along with Travaris Tillman in that secondary for Miami. Tillman last week came up with an interception in the loss to Cleveland. 3 receiver set. Here's Collins stepping up in trouble. And Collins is sacked. David Bowens coming through and able to dump Kerry Collins on the first possession of the day.
Well, Bowens is doing a really good job of coming off the ball. They bring pressure off the left side. They force him to step up into the pocket, but they're still able to get to the quarterback by running the stunt, bringing Kevin Carter, the defensive end, under inside. Bowens loops around for the secondary pressure on Kerry Collins.
Ron Stone was unable to handle him. And Oakland is forced to pick up punt. Shane Lechner, the best in the NFL. High kick, but not one of his best as it went to the outside. We'll see where they spot it. And it's going to be just around midfield. Just a 34-yard punt for Shane Lechner. As the game goes on here today, we had a chance to sit down with Saban yesterday. Three receivers set on a first and 10. They open up on Oakland's end of the field. For Rock, comfortable in the pocket. Now sacked from behind. Excellent play coming through. And a loss of four on the play. Derek Burgess with the sack. Damian McIntosh, part of the offensive line that has now allowed 15 sacks on the season. Backs and receivers. Ricky Williams coming off his best game of the season. He had 83 yards rushing a week ago. Handoff, it's Ronnie Brown slicing through a hole. And he crosses the 45. And a 7-yard gain. Bobby Hamilton in on that stop. Burgess has been on an absolute mission. His 10th sack of the season. Changes on the defensive line. Tommy Kelly shifts inside. Warren Sapp done for the year with a shoulder injury. Linebackers, Tyler Braden, you'll see him on the sideline as well, depending upon what package they use on defense. And in the secondary, the rookie Fabian Washington has been forced into duty because of injuries. Charles Woodson is out. Washington last week did have a forced fumble in that win over Washington. Take the handoff. Farrakh steps up. Farrakh throwing. Deep ball. Separation. Catch made. Brian Gilmore. And he's got it for the touchdown. Farrakh put it on the money. And Miami strikes first.
And they pick on Fabian Washington. And watch Gilmore at the top of the screen. It's just a sprint to the end zone. And Washington drops coverage, maybe expecting Stuart Schwager to come over the top, but he only needs one step, and Gilmore just burns him into the end zone for a touchdown.
First touchdown of the season for Brian Gilmore in his fifth year at a Midwestern state. They picked him up off of waivers last year as Mari adds the extra point. And this crowd has quieted down in a hurry. The strike for Rott to Gilmore. 7-0 Dolphins. A new career long for Brian Gilmore. 44-yard touchdown on the pass from Farrakh. And Miami in front 7-0 with 11:58 to go in the first quarter. Mare will kick it off again. Chris Carr is waiting. And returnable as Carr will take it out of the end zone. Here's Carr, and he is upended, shy of the 20-yard line. Travaris Tillman, first man downfield, to make that play.
And Ian, what you have is a basic cover two with the safeties deep, but he doesn't get over the top, and Gilmore just sprints to the end zone. The rookie Fabian Washington at the corner position is expecting Stuart Schwager to get over the top. Schwager hangs in the middle over the slot receiver, cannot get out on the perimeter to prevent the touchdown by Gilmore.
And give credit to Farrakh as well, who put the ball exactly where it had to be for Brian Gilmore.
And how about the protection by the offensive line, which is what the coaches, Nick Saban, said would be paramount for this offense for the Miami Dolphins today.
7-0, Miami with the lead. And Oakland takes over with a first and 10. And it's on 18-yard line. Handoff to Lamont Jordan, trying to get out in space. And Jordan is able to shuffle his way for a gain of 6 on first down. Oh, he told you about the injuries on both sides. How about the linebacker position for the Miami Dolphins today? Zach Thomas suffered that shoulder injury last week. Junior Seau, his season is over. With Thomas, we don't know exactly when he's going to be back. We do know he's going to be seeing Dr. James Andrews tomorrow. And he's also got a high ankle sprain.
And Jenny Crowder is the young rookie that has to step in for Zach Thomas, provide leadership at the middle linebacker position.
Through a hole, and Lamont Jordan has got a 5-yard gain and a first down for Oakland. Jordan leading this team in rushing yards and receptions overall. I think it's been the one surprise that Jordan has brought, his ability to catch the ball out of the backfield. He was a bit of a mystery in that category from his New York Jet days.
And Norv Turner said it. I didn't know much about him. We knew he was a good player. We knew he would be a good addition. But I think he surprised everyone with the Oakland Raiders, his ability to not only run the ball, but to catch the ball out of the backfield. And has, I think, added some leadership qualities also.
Three receivers set. Collins, Pump, Collins, deep ball. There's separation, but too far for Alvis Whitted. The former track star could not track that one down over his shoulder. And Collins just missed out on a golden opportunity.
And he got behind this secondary. We told you in the open that they were going to go up top. They would need to hit some home runs with the wide receivers. Alvis Whitted is behind the defense. And they just overthrow him. Kerry Collins overthrows Whitted and throws it over the wrong shoulder. Throws it over that outside shoulder. That was an easy layup for the offense to hit the big play.
Would have been 6 points and the equalizer for Oakland. Instead, second and 10. Jordan running with a purpose. But not much there as he stumbles for a gain of 4. Channing Crowder, Florida rookie, combining with Keith Traylor to bring down Lamont Jordan.
Now, I think it's going to be important for the young linebackers to play well. And we're talking about Channing Crowder, Derek Pope, Donnie Spragans. When you're young and you're energetic, you get in that first game, the adrenaline is flowing. And sometimes you tend to be too fast to rush to the football, and you allow the cutback by the runner to go out the back door. So they're going to have to be very sound and disciplined in their rush lanes.
Now a 3rd and 6. Collins in the pocket. Swing pass to Jordan. And loses the football. Jordan was trying to extend the arm. He wasn't even close to a first down, but he'll be ruled down. The whistle blew. Vonnie Holiday on the recovery, but no harm done.
Yeah, Jordan's trying to do too much here. He's nowhere close to the first down, but still exposes this ball and nearly creates a turnover situation. I think that's where he has to settle down, too, and the coaches talk about. He wants to hit the home run every time he gets the ball. Has to do a better job of understanding the situation and taking the opportunity when it presents itself.
Here's the punt from Leckler. Did not get off a good one on his first opportunity. This one a little better, but still not the standard of which we're accustomed to from Shane Leckler. It will go down as a 33-yard punt. And Miami will get the football back, already leading the Raiders 7-0 here in Oakland. Squad and avoided a fate this year. What was next year? Long pass to Chambers on first down. And it's incomplete. Fabian Washington had the coverage. It'll be 2nd and 10.
Oh, the Dolphins are coming out and taking some shots with their receivers. They're going to get a lot of single coverage on the outside. Fabian Washington appears to be the one they want to go after. He's the rookie and has played, I think, pretty good football over the last couple of weeks. They're expecting Chris Chambers to be able to make some plays, the veteran wide receiver working against the rookie.
Another quick snap. This time a handoff to Ronnie Brown running into a crowd, and he picks up 3. Kirk Morrison making that tackle for Oakland and the injury report for the Raiders. Warren Sapp, we were told yesterday, injured reserve, and earlier in the week, the initial thought was, all right, he's not going to play this week because of the shoulder, but he will return. Not the case. MRI performed on Wednesday. Sapp is done for the year. Woodson has missed extended action because of that leg injury, and the Raiders have to move on.
And Sapp was having a good year since going back to that 4-3 front. He had been playing well, but other guys, Tommy Kelly and Jasper, playing well.
On a direct snap to Ronnie Brown, and he's got a first down. Loses the ball at the end of the play as a flag came down. Dolphins ranged over. Raiders were there, and they get the football. Well, how about that? You got a direct snap to Brown. You got a penalty marker on the play and a Stuart Schweigert recovery on a 15-yard run.
And they're going to talk about it. There is a flag down. But what do we talk about? Young runners in the National Football League understanding the moment. You had already made a big play. Just protect the football and live to fight another day.
Ron Winter.
Rolling on the field, there's a fumble recovered by the defense before going out of bounds. Holding, offense number 68, a penalty decline, first down.
So the Miami Dolphins turn it over. And Ronnie Brown, who had made a terrific play to get the first down, coughs it up.
The play by design, I think, was an excellent play. The direct snap, but Stuart Swigert punches the ball out, and then the Raiders are able to pounce on it before going out of bounds.
Well, the Miami Dolphins have now gone 20 consecutive games with at least one turnover. Nick Saban, during that timeout, was clutching the red flag, and now he's thrown it. This could be one of two issues, Solomon. One being, was Ronnie Brown already down? Or two, were the Raiders out of bounds when they recovered the ball along the sideline?
I think both are close calls and a wise
Miami
choice by Nick Saban.
Miami is rolling down the field, but the fumble was recovered inbounds.
Well, there you go. So Stuart Swigert, who was out along the sideline, was he inbounds holding on to this football? There's the roll, 29, kept it in. It's going to be a tight call. Back here in Oakland with the Miami Dolphins leading it 7-0. The question right now for Ron Winter, was Reggie Tongue out of bounds when he touched this ball to keep it alive for Swigert?
Watch his shoulders hit out of bounds and see if his foot is still with the ball. It looked like the ball was still making contact with his leg when that shoulder made contact with the out-of-bounds line. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what the officials say, because it's certainly open to interpretation. I think maybe several pair of eyes could see the same thing, but, you know, interpret it differently.
There's no question on Swigert. He gets the ball clean. The only question is with Reggie Tongue and whether his back was lying out of bounds as it made contact with his foot.
You know, the ball was rolling around his legs and then his foot, then his upper body went out of bounds.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. First down, Oakland.
Yep.
Miami is charged with a timeout.
That's Ron Winter's take on it. And that's the way it's going to stay. Raiders take over with a first and 10, and Nick Saban loses a timeout.
Good interpretation, because I don't think it's clear that the ball was hitting his legs as he went out. I think, as we said, a couple of pair of eyes could see it and maybe interpret it differently. They're going to say that he did not make contact with the ball as he went out.
So after the turnover by Ronnie Brown, Raiders with a first down at the 48-yard line. And off, Jordan. And sticks the helmet down, leans forward to pick up 5 yards and set up a second and 5. For Oakland. Randy Moss will come back onto the field. He was not on the field for that first down play. Lamont Jordan, you've been impressed with his time so far as a Raider?
I have been impressed. His ability to rush for over 600 yards and have over 400 yards receiving, the only running back in the National Football League with those kinds of numbers. 52 receptions out of the backfield. I think he has been a weapon for Kerry Collins in this offense.
Well, so far he's been the only weapon for Kerry Collins. He's the only Raider to touch the football. There's Collins, and unable to get it to Jordan. So it'll be 3rd and 5 for Oakland.
Now right now, Kerry Collins has gotten off to a very bad start, because there's a couple of times he's had the protection and the time to hit receivers wide open down the field. Alvis with it earlier in this game, and then just there checking the ball down to Lamont Jordan. He was wide open. No reason why Kerry Collins should not have completed that pass.
Doug Gabriel comes on as a third receiver, along with Moss and Porter for Oakland. Dime package right now for Miami on a 3rd and 5. Look out. Collins, ball is knocked free. It's lying on the ground. Jason Taylor was the one who knocked it loose. Pushing and shoving between the Raiders and Dolphins to recover it. And Oakland does get it back, but the Raiders do nothing with that excellent field position.
You force him into 3rd and long, and then you can pin your ears back. And watch Taylor against Barry Sims, the left tackle. He blows right by him off the line of scrimmage. Kerry Collins didn't have a chance. Smart by Jason Taylor to go for the football. That ball's just sitting on the ground, resting on the back of Kerry Collins, but it's an excellent pass rush. This is what North Turner was really afraid of. He knows that Jason Taylor can take over a football game.
David Bowens went limping off for Miami as Leckler uncorks his 3rd punt. And that one will take a Miami roll. Raiders will touch it up at the 34-yard line. And it's a 24-yard punt for Leckler. Who knows what's wrong with him so far today. 7-0, Dolphins in front. Strange start to this one. Miami with a 7-0 lead. 7:07 to go in the first quarter. And the Dolphins with a 1st and 10 at their own 34.
Give credit to the Dolphins defense for pitching that 3-and-out after the turnover by the offense.
Ricky Williams in there for Miami. And a 3-receiver set. Williams gets the call. And runs into a wall as he picked up a couple. Tommy Kelly, first man there. We'll give him a gain of 3 on first down. So for Williams, 13 carries, 83 yards last week. Can this work, sharing carries with Williams and Ronnie Brown?
I think it has worked. In 3 of their last 4 games, they've averaged over 4.0 yards per carry, no matter who they're running. I think right now the most improved part of this football team has to be the Dolphins' offensive line.
2nd and 7, play action. Farrakh has got time. Farrakh throwing, incomplete. Randy McMichael had it. And the coverage from Fabian Washington.
And that time you saw the protection provided by that offensive line protecting Gus Farrakh, gave him ample time to look down the field and get the ball over to McMichael. See, he has the double catch. You have to hold on to it the first time. Fabian Washington continues the fight and is able to break it up. And what did Nick Saban tell us? He said, hey, we need our skilled players to start making plays, and we have to finish games. But right now, they just need Randy McMichael, to, once he makes that catch, to hold on to the ball.
Yeah, McMichael got off to a good start this season. Looked like he was going to have a Pro Bowl-type campaign. He's been quiet of late. Farrakh finds the open man. It's Chris Chambers into Oakland territory. Farrakh, who mishandled the snap initially, is able to recover for a 16-yard hookup to his number one wideout.
He's able to hold on to it because the protection was good. And Gus Farrakh has had his ups and downs so far this year. First 4 games, you look at the numbers, still about 50-50 with this touchdown interception ratio. And then the last 6 games, the interceptions have come, the 4 throws have come, and then he's been inconsistent at best.
Ricky Williams, a little stutter step move for a gain of a couple. Ronaldo Hill in on that stop for Oakland.
But I talk about it. It all starts there. They have the skilled players, and now those guys have to come through and be more consistent.
Now they're just not turning it into wins, though. 3 straight losses for the Dolphins. Farrakh throwing incomplete with a penalty marker down. He was looking for Brian Gilmore. Should have brought that one in. But a flag on the play thrown at the 44-yard line. Winter's a busy man.
Offside. Defense number 93. In the neutral zone to snap. 5-yard penalty. Repeat 2nd down.
So they had a free play because of Tommy Kelly jumping offsides. And you're going to see mixing and matching on that D-line in the absence of Sapp. Kelly, Ed Jasper, Terdell Sands, as Rob Ryan, the defensive coordinator, looks for the right combination.
Well, they've got a good combination because they run this 4-2-5. They use 5 defensive backs. It's like that big nickel package. And they play well against the run and play pretty good against the pass, other than that first quarter touchdown.
2nd and 3. Farrakh, play fake. Deep one. Incomplete. Sliding attempt by Chambers. And it'll be 3rd down for Miami.
He's on the perimeter because they play 3 safeties on the field at a time, trying to provide an 8-man front to stop the run of the Miami Dolphins.
There is Farrakh on a roll, throwing on the run. Wide open, Wes Welker. And a 1st down for the Dolphins. Jared Cooper making the hit along the sideline. That covers 16 yards, and this drive continues.
And you get the sense that with the protection, no doubt it looks like they can move the ball against this Raiders defense.
Marty Booker has a calf injury. Wide receiver for the Dolphins. His return is questionable. Handoff, Ricky Williams. And able to fall forward for a pickup of 4 as we hit 4.5 minutes to play in this first quarter.
And already all that matters because they definitely have responded here in the first quarter.
So far, 105 yards of offense. Compare that to Oakland's 11 yards of offense. 2nd and 6. Pump fake. Farrakh looking for the touchdown, and it's intercepted. Stuart Schweiger down the sideline. He gets level. But the Raiders come up with the pick.
Got to keep your head on a swivel, Stuart. Those linemen can hit, but excellent play on the football. Gus Farrakh commits a cardinal mistake. Watch, he wants to go to his right. He comes clear back to the other side. Late, Stuart Schwager is waiting for this one. Shows excellent ability in hands, coming up with a huge interception for the Raiders.
Today, MetLife is navigating the skies above Oakland, providing aerial coverage of all the football action. Look to the skies for the MetLife glimpse as they team up with CBS for more coverage in December. Just the third interception, believe it or not, this season for the Oakland defense. Stuart Schwager, his first of the year, and the pick from Gus Frerotte. Raiders have it, first and 10 at their own 31. Collins, give to Jordan. He's got a hold. And Jordan stays on his feet. Flag down as he crossed midfield into Miami territory. And it's thrown back at the line of scrimmage. A 22-yard run, but looks like it's coming back.
Holding. Offense number 70. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
And Brad Badger is called on the hold, negating the 22-yard rip.
This Oakland Raiders offense finding it difficult to get going. Having mistakes, overthrowing wide-open receivers, underthrowing them, and now the call on Badger brings back an excellent run by Lamont Jordan. But I think if you're the Raiders, you have to continue to pound the running game. They've yet to throw the ball over to Randy Moss. I don't know how long he's going to sit back and allow that to happen. I think eventually you have to start trying to get the ball to Randy, allow him to make some plays against a very vulnerable Miami Dolphins secondary.
Now, right now he's matched up with a rookie, Travis Daniels out of LSU. They'll stay with the ground game. And Jordan gets stacked up. He picks up two. Coming up, the Sprint Halftime Report. Greg, Dan, Shannon, and times for 26 yards. Yeah, the big question about Moss, how healthy is he? Groin injury, rib problems, pelvis injury. Cut practice short on Friday. Just haven't seen him yet. Here's Collins. Got the time and throws it underneath to guess who? Lamont Jordan. And Jordan able to fight for extra yardage and pick up the first down.
And this is what I mean by learning how to run in situations. He understood where the first down marker was, gave that little stutter step, made sure he made it to the first down marker. At least he's going to be very close.
Yeah, they're not going to give it to him.
But an excellent move, and you could tell he had understanding of the situation and where he was on the football field.
Either way, it sets up a third and short, but they're going to claim that he came up shy of that first down line by about a yard. So a three tight end formation. And it's Jordan again. Turning it upfield and falling down. He lost yardage on the play. It has been Lamont Jordan against the Miami defense. That's it. No one else has touched the ball for Oakland so far.
And you know they believe they have confidence. The right side of that offensive line didn't get it done, but has been a dual threat in this Oakland Raiders offense. You see the rushing yards and receiving yards representing 33% of their total offense. So that's what they brought him over here for. And what did Norv Turner tell us? Said he believes Lamont Jordan's going to be even better in his second year as a full-time starter in this offense.
There's Leckler. Wes Welker moves forward, and a fair catch. He had room in front of him. I think Welker is respecting the abilities of Leckler. And the reality was it was a 34-yard punt. And time for us to pause for the wisdom of Solomon.
Well, on season, the Rams, they've already gotten it going.
Minute 39 to go in this first quarter. Handoff to Ricky Williams. And nothing doing. Williams is denied by Ted Washington and Tommy Kelly. No gain on the play with a minute 25 and counting left in this first quarter.
Speaking of coaching changes, remember Nick Saban was brought over to get the Miami Dolphins going in the right direction. And he made some comments this week. I think it was kind of taken out of context. I think it's very clear. When we talked to him in week two, he was clear in what he said. Hey, the focus is on doing the little things and everything else will take care of itself. And I think that message has always been the same.
And Frerotte incomplete to Randy McMichael. It'll set up third and 10. He told us in our sit-down.
But if you would ask that player, okay, how are you going to go about it? That's where I think you would get silence, because a lot of people don't know how to win. And he wants his players to focus on the how. If we do the little things, if we focus on tackling and blocking, then everything else takes care of itself.
On third down, released by Ricky Williams, and he comes up short of the first down marker. Jared Cooper made sure of it. And he picked up 7 when he needed 10. So Miami will punt.
And one, trying to get young players in, looking at other guys. He really was speaking to, hey, we're going to continue to work like we always have. And just because our record is 3-7, we're not going to change what we're doing.
Big punt from Jones to Chris Carr. And Carr is stamped as he hit the 15-yard line by the snapper John Denny. A 54-yard punt and just a 5-yard return.
On offense, and I think surprisingly, their defense is better than what most people think.
And you can cast your vote at NFL.com. I think with Roethlisberger under center, Pittsburgh's got to be in the conversation.
There's no doubt. I want to see him get back and get some games under his belt right now.
Hand off to Lamont Jordan. I think games just a yard. Kevin Carter among those there for Miami to bring down Jordan. Oakland is not deviating from the game plan right now. And we have come to an end of the first quarter. Well, Miami, one big play, and that's enough to be the difference so far. 7-0, Dolphins. And welcome back, McAfee Coliseum in Oakland, California. Dolphins 7, Raiders nothing as we start play in the second quarter. Ian Eagle, Solomon Wilcox, and the rest of our CBS crew. Collins, play action. Collins, hit as he throws, and it's incomplete. And he was locked in on Lamont Jordan. Now, we're not exaggerating when we say it's been all Jordan. Nobody else for Oakland on offense.
Well, it's also been Jason Taylor coming off the corner against Barry Sims, the left tackle. And I think it's leaving the quarterback, Kerry Collins, very vulnerable. You see him coming in. Watch the pressure coming up the front and then from the backside. And so it's the relentless effort of Jason Taylor that's really not allowing Kerry Collins and this Oakland Raider offense to get the ball down the field to the likes of Randy Moss and Jerry Ford.
And he got sandwiched on that play with Taylor, as you mentioned, and Kevin Carter helping on the front side. This is a 3rd and 9 in the pocket. Collins has the time, throwing to a spot, and hauled in by Porter. First down for Oakland at the 46-yard line with Reggie Howard and Travaris Tillman in coverage.
Protection is not only for the quarterback, but it's also for the receivers to be able to get downfield. And watch Jerry Porter working in the slot, comes out on that corner route. Ball hung up a little, but he turns around, makes the excellent catch. It all starts with the protection by the offensive line. And in that time, Kerry Collins made an excellent throw. And what a catch by Porter.
Porter has that acrobatic ability. Now watching from the sideline on a 1st and 10. Collins throwing. Nobody home and a flag down. Jordan was in the area. Too high for the Oakland running back. But a penalty marker at the 42-yard line of Miami.
And North Turner's not afraid to go deep. Right after the sack by Jason Taylor, they call another play.
Defense. 5-yard penalty. And a 1st down.
So a defensive hold is called against Nick Saban's club. Move it 5 yards. And spot the football at the 49 of Miami. On a 1st and 10. In Dolphin territory with the Dolphins in front 7-0. Back to the bread and butter. It's Jordan. Shake and bake move as Jordan crosses the 45. And he picks up about 4 yards on 1st down.
Everywhere North Turner has been, he's never been shy about being committed and staying patient with the running game. Here he has Lamont Jordan. So North Turner understands that I can get the linebackers, the young linebackers of the Miami Dolphins, to bite up to the line of scrimmage. They're going to continue to come with more play action. He'll just lull you to sleep, patiently using the running game, and then he's going to try to strike quickly with a deep pass over the top.
On a 2nd down and 7, Jordan again. And hit in the backfield. Unable to break free of Keith Traylor. The big nose tackle for the Dolphins. A loss of 2 on the play.
Well, he is the big guy, and boy, can he come off the ball. He's going to be here. He'll just come in, getting right underneath the center. And watch how he just comes right in. And they can't hold him off. and they can't keep him out of the backfield. Lamont Jordan had no chance of getting away from Keith Traylor.
The two-gap run stuffer for this Miami defensive line. Now in his 15th year in the NFL. And a third and nine for Oakland. Three receiver formation. Rush is coming. And flags come down. Now this Raiders offense cannot find a rhythm.
False start. Offense number 85. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
And that one against Doug Gabriel, the third year receiver out of Central Florida.
And that's when you're asked to come off the field. North Turner says, yeah, you can come over and stand by me. We'll put Alvis Whitted in. Maybe we can get the playoff. Because now you're facing a third and 14. You know the Dolphins are going to come after the quarterback, and they're going to try to force a quick throw by Collins so they can make the tackle before the ball advances beyond that first down mark.
So back it up to the Oakland 48. Third and long for Collins and the Raiders. As the protection, the throw on the money. And a first down to Alvis Whitted. Coverage from Travis Daniels and an 18-yard strike from Kerry Collins.
And they tried to come after Collins, but that time the protection held up. And it's a small window to throw this ball. Watch Whitted's going to be surrounded by at least four defenders. He goes beyond the first down marker, but look, you've got four defenders in the area, and Kerry Collins just threw this one through a very small window, hitting Whitted beyond that first down mark.
And a first and 10 at the Miami 34, with the Dolphins leading this one 7-0. Early stages, second quarter. Play action. Collins has the time. Collins, a throw to the sideline. Randy Moss. First down Raiders. At the 16-yard line, and Moss finally gets involved with an 18-yard hookup.
Well, they tell us he works hard when the ball's coming his way. And look at the throw by Collins. This ball's high. But Randy has the ability and the height and vertical jump to go up and haul it in and still come down with both feet in bounds. Sometimes he makes it look too easy, Ian.
36th catch for the five-time Pro Bowler. And the eighth play of the drive coming up here. Collins is now 6 of 9 for 104 yards. Make the handoff. Collins steps up. And Collins throws. That ball was possibly tipped. But Kevin Carter got a clean shot on Kerry Collins. Incomplete.
Kerry Collins is the kind of guy that he's going to stand in the pocket. When you look at what he's done since the 2000 season, he ranks very high in attempts, completions, yards, and about ninth in touchdowns. And then, you know what, he's avoiding throwing those interceptions. So that's the thing. Kerry Collins, if he protects the football, he can help you win some games.
Kerry Collins, last week, the second pass of the game was intercepted by Lamar Marshall and returned for a touchdown. Here's Collins in the pocket. Collins throwing. And a flag down. It's incomplete. Jason Taylor had an opportunity. And Jordan was the intended target. This flag's going to work against Miami.
Holding. Offense, defense number 99. 5-yard penalty. And a first down.
And it's Taylor.
That'll help you get in position, get an interception. You know, Jason Taylor, this is one of the things they're asking him to do more in this defense. We know he can rush the passer, but I think the adjustment this year in this defense, he's been asked to drop back in coverage and make plays. You see, he has the ability, just has to catch the ball, keep his hands off the receiver, move his feet, and make a play on the ball.
First and 10 for Oakland from the Miami 11. Handoff. Jordan, spin move. And devoured. Good play by Derek Pope. The second-year linebacker able to make the stop on Jordan. It's a loss of one. It'll be second and 11.
And so far, I think the linebackers, Crowder, Pope, and Spragans, they've done, I think, a very good job without Junior Seau or Zach Thomas in there. Right now, the Raiders, you see inside the red zone, ranked 24th in the National Football League. But this Miami Dolphins defense right now with the young linebackers, I think they're holding up pretty good.
On second down, Raiders looking to tie this one up. Collins throwing, complete. Courtney Anderson rolling towards the goal line. And he's down before he's able to hit Pater. Sam Madison hit him down low. But depending on the spot, they might set this one up first and goal inside the one.
Now watch Anderson coming across the formation right into the camera. And look at the tackle there by Sam Madison. He doesn't make this tackle on a very big, mobile Courtney Anderson. He's going to score a touchdown. It's little man against big man, and little man wins.
First and goal inside the one. Jordan and Crockett in the backfield. Oakland can tie it up. Handoff. Jordan up in the air for the touchdown. So the Raiders put together an 11-play, 85-yard drive and an extra point away from tying it up at 7.
Well, it starts with the offensive line providing protection for Collins and ends with the offensive line opening a hole for Lamont Jordan to go up and over for the touchdown. And I think that's really what has gotten the Raiders back into this ballgame.
So for Jordan, that is his 8th rushing touchdown of the season. Janikowski, the extra point. All knotted at 7 with 9:34 to go in this first half. Now the Raiders made a couple of big plays on that possession to keep the drive alive. And they get the 7. Lamont Jordan goes for the 1-yard touchdown, airborne to pick it up. And the kickoff from Janikowski. Wes Welker is deep. He'll take it out of the end zone. Here's Welker down the middle through a hole. Welker, and able to work his way to the 37-yard line before Jared Cooper made the stop on special teams, a 41-yard return. All tied up, old AFC rivals going head-to-head. Miami Dolphins 7, Oakland Raiders 7, with 9:28 to go in this second quarter. Dolphins on a 1st and 10. Ball was deflected by Bobby Hamilton. Off the throw from Gus Frerotte, who is now in his 12th year in the NFL. And Frerotte started his career in Washington. Who was the head coach then?
North Turner.
And Turner gave Gus his first opportunity in the NFL. Has had a number of stops along the way with Detroit, Denver, Cincinnati, Minnesota, and Miami. And in all of those stops, he has at least started one game. So he's one of only 4 players since the merger to start for 6 different teams. Ricky Williams off the direct snap, and the Raiders were ready for it with Danny Clark leading that charge for Oakland. The other guys, Solomon, Steve DeBerg, Chris Chandler, and our very own colleague here at CBS Sports, Steve Berline.
Steve Berline's been around the National Football League, and now still making the rounds calling games with us here at CBS. But Gus Frerotte is one of those guys that, you know, we talked to North Turner about it, what has been the thing with him. He says, well, he said, hey, he can make all the throws. Gus Frerotte just needs to be consistent over the long haul. He's going to have that opportunity with Miami.
Frerotte was drafted in the 7th round by Turner. They saw a big upside, and he developed quickly. Frerotte devoured. Tommy Kelly was there. Jared Cooper was there. Derek Burgess applied that pressure as well for Oakland.
Well, you're right. Everyone was there. Look, they're going to come here, come here, come here, and they just collapse the pocket, and they have that 4-2-5 defense, so it's double coverage on the back end. It's a coverage sack as much as it is anything because there was nowhere to go with the football.
Punt from Donnie Jones. Chris Carr waiting. Back pedals, and here's Carr trying to make a move to the outside. He's got a block. And Carr comes up short of the 30-yard line. A 12-yard return after the 53-yard punt. The stick by Travaris Tillman out along the perimeter. Actions pick it up here in Oakland. We're tied at 7. All tied at 7 here in the second quarter in Oakland. 8:23 to go in the first half. Raiders out for the 1st and 10. Play fake. Collins steps up in the pocket, and Collins caught from behind by Vonnie Holiday. No gain on the play as Collins was looking to break free, and Holiday would have none of it.
Well, it's actually, they're going to come after him a bit. It's a play action. They want to go down the field to Randy Moss, but you see the protection break down. Kerry Collins steps up in the pocket, doing a good job of just holding on to the ball. But Vonnie Holiday and the rest of that Miami Dolphins front line is providing pressure without having to blitz.
Collins certainly not known for his spry footwork. As he hands off to Jordan, runs into a wall, cuts it to the outside. But look at all the white jerseys in the vicinity. Bonnie Holiday, first man there to deal with Jordan. It's a loss of one. Visit CBS Sportsline tonight for a complete. So now the Raiders with a third and 11 in front of them. Jordan averaging just 2 yards per carry here in the first half. On third down, protection is there. Collins throwing over the middle. It's complete to Porter. And a flag down back at the 27-yard line as Porter makes the catch cleanly at the 43. 17-yard pass completion.
It was a free play because there was the hard count. Kerry Collins pulled him off.
Defense number 96 in the neutral zone to snap. Penalties decline. Play results in a first down.
Well, they'll turn down the David Bowens offsides because they got the first down the hard way.
And the protection has been inconsistent. Kerry Collins has been sacked already 3 times in this ballgame, but North Turner still not shy to call the deep in-cut routes by the receivers where you have to have protection in order to complete that pass.
Miami Dolphins have suffered 9 straight road losses to teams from the AFC. Handoff to Jordan. And a little spin move for Jordan gets him a gain of 2. As the Dolphins are very prepared against the run.
Yeah, they're also prepared against the pass in terms of putting pressure on the quarterback, getting hits. And we said that they would have to hit the rash the quarterback. That's what they've done to Kerry Collins. Not just the 3 sacks on the day, but other times when the pressure has been there, forced maybe some bad throws when the coverage hasn't held up on the back end.
And the Dolphins have lost the time of possession battle in 8 of their last 9 games. It's basically double right now in favor of Oakland in that category. Here's Collins with a deep drop. Steps up, able to avoid the pressure, but can't make the connection to Anderson, the tight end. It'll be 3rd and 8. The linebacker, Donnie Spragan, had the coverage.
Spragan's getting the start at that outside linebacker position, but in holding up, we say they've done a good job, I think, against the run. We already said how Lamont Jordan, in terms of his yards per carry, not real high in this game, I think, because of the linebackers, Donnie Spragan, Crowder, and Derek Polk. They're doing, I think, a really fine job in this game.
So this will be a 3rd and long for Oakland. Collins in the pocket. Collins thrown down. Bonnie Holiday just tossed Collins to the turf, and the Raiders will punt again.
Already now 4 sacks by the Miami Dolphins on defense. And so they're able to come off this right side, and that's where the pressure is. But they've come up the middle today. Holiday lined up at that tackle position. He's getting the push right in the face of Kerry Collins.
26th sack this season that the Raiders' offensive line has given up. And Shane Lechler the punt. And again, it takes a Miami bounce. And Lechler is just not himself today. That'll be a 25-yard punt for Lechler. The Pro Bowler with a powerful leg has not been getting it done in this first half. Dolphins get the football back when we return. That dresses up together, stays together. There's my motto.
They love their Raiders.
They do. Tied at 7, Raiders and Dolphins. 1st and 10, Miami. On a quick hitter. Randy McMichael able to get a 1st down into Oakland territory. He picks up 15 yards on the catch and run for the Dolphins. Log on to NFL.com from now until the end of the season on AOL. Gus Frerotte, 5 of 11 so far for McMichael. His first catch of the day and a 1st and 10 at the Oakland 48. Draw play. Ronnie Brown. Juke move by Brown, and he's able to get a solid gainer on 1st down. He picks up 6.
The Raider defense, we talk about ranked 22nd overall. They're beginning to improve because they're now starting to get younger players on the field who are starting to produce. Still have the veterans like Bobby Hamilton, who's now healthy. And then if you throw in Derek Burgess, who played very well, this defense, I believe, is on the rise.
2nd and 4 for the Dolphins. To the ground, Brown. And he's going to come up short of a 1st down. Danny Clark among those there on the stop for the Oakland Raiders. And a gain of 2 for Miami. Yeah, what do you make of this 4-2-5 on defense? Is it something that we see a lot in the NFL?
No, you don't see a lot of it. And I think the reason why they're doing it, they're wanting to get more of their athletes on the football field using four down linemen, two linebackers, and then three safeties. Rob Ryan wanting to get guys like Ronaldo Hill. Even though he's 5'11", 190, he's a good tackler. And then if you throw in Gerard Cooper, those two safeties on the outside, they can play the run and the pass equally well.
On a third and two, Brown trying to push the pile. He's got enough. And a first down for Miami. This drive remains alive for the Dolphins.
And only 42 rush yards against this Oakland Raider defense so far in the game. You expect the Dolphins to be able to run it in chunks with Ronnie Brown and Ricky Williams running the ball, but you know, both running backs, they're very good in their own right, doing so many things well for Nick Saban in this offense. But right now, the Raiders defense holding up against the run game of the Miami Dolphins.
Now, Miami had 194 yards of total offense last week. They had 132 yards of offense in the first half today. Little jump on the line. Flag comes down. And the quick out to Chris Chambers. But a penalty marker, as mentioned, on the play. We'll see if the 5-yard pass will stand for Miami. Looked like movement on both sides. Who was the guilty party?
Offside. Defense number 95 in the neutral zone to snap. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Now it's the veteran defense now at the 33-yard line. Penalties continue to accumulate for Oakland, six of them against the Raiders. Handoff to Ronnie Brown, the rookie. And a spin move to no avail. Tyler Brayton was able to sniff it out and limit Brown to a gain of one.
Tyler Brayton was the one who wrecked the play. It was his initial penetration that I think created problems for that run play. And that's what you mean by improvement on defense. There are times when teams would come in here and just really were able to run and throw the ball against this Raiders defense. So you see them starting to make an impact and starting to make plays.
We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter with Miami and Oakland deadlocked at 7. Like Blimps, Snoopy 2 is providing today's aerial coverage of the action here in Oakland. The Blimps provide coverage of over 70 sporting events and television specials throughout the United States each year. In fact, look for the MetLife Blimp Snoopy 2 as it teams up with CBS again next weekend in Miami. Farrakh forced to throw it away because of the heat provided by Bobby Hamilton. And a penalty marker thrown. Farrakh claiming that he threw it at the feet of a teammate.
Yeah, but the ball did not make it back to the line of scrimmage, and he still was in the pocket in between the tackles. So they're going to call it illegal grounding because he was definitely under pressure and was trying to just get rid of the football to avoid the sack.
Ron Winter having a little chat with his line judge, Tom Stefan.
There is no foul for intentional grounding as receiver number 23 is in the area. Third down.
I think they had it right in the first place. And he throws the ball at the feet of the receiver in the area. And see the immediate pressure? And see, Ronnie Brown's not even looking back. And the ball is thrown, I think, to the left of where Ronnie Brown was. I think they had the call right in this one.
So they'll take the flag back and set it up with a third and four from the 32 of Oakland. Pivotal play here for the Dolphins on offense. Shotgun for Rock. Handling the pressure. Side on toss. Complete to Chambers and a first down for Miami. A 6-yard gain through the air and a new set of downs for the Dolphins to work with. Coming up, Sprint Halftime Report. Greg, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer have the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Clock is moving, a minute 27 left. First half, second catch of the day for Chambers. On first down, handoff to Brown. And Brown is stacked up and finished off on the play by Terdell Sands. Bobby Hamilton, first man there, a gain of one.
And nine as the Dolphins knock on the door of the red zone. Remember, last time they was in this position, Gus Farrakh made a fatal mistake, threw the interception to Stuart Swaggart. And it was just a poor decision on his part. And so you want to get points on the board before halftime think you have to understand, yeah, we want to get a touchdown, but let's make a wise decision, good choice with the football.
Miami lost a timeout earlier. A challenge from Nick Saban. Did not stand up for Ruff. Complete to Chambers, short of the goal line. Schweigert with the hit. But it's a 23-yard pass play, and the Dolphins are knocking on the door.
Good decision, good execution by Gus Frerotte. Watch Chambers goes across the formation, getting the ball over the linebacker and in between the safety and cornerback. And so it's a crowded area, very small window, but it's an excellent time to throw the ball. You're just outside that 20-yard line. If you're going to take a shot, that's a good area to do it.
And Miami will use one of its two remaining timeouts, and they'll have a first and goal at the one with a chance to take the lead before we hit the halftime break. So Gus Frerotte has found some holes in this Rob Ryan design defense. Now Frerotte last week, 4 of 18, 53 yards, playing with that sprained right index finger. Can't tape it, can't really do anything with it. He's just got to accept the pain.
I think he's doing a good job of making decisions. He said the swelling went down. I asked him, what happened last week? He said, I wasn't able to practice last week. And, you know, he said, I came in that game, filled in for Sage Rosenfels. He said, I was just looking to make a play. So we had to take some shots.
On first and goal, handoff. Roddy Brown toppled over. Did he get in? Dolphins want a signal. Ball has squirted loose in the end zone. Frerotte holds up his arms, and the officials still haven't made the call.
Well, one official put his arms up, but want to ask the other guys, what'd you see? One official's already said it was a touchdown, and I think they're going to go in that direction.
So Miami's going to get the touchdown.
Let's see if he made it in. Here's the dive.
Timeout.
Can't really quite see with that. Okay, he comes in and is able to extend the ball beyond the goal line. I think he did break the plane of the goal line before he hit the ground. See the ball out right there? From our other angle, we could see that that ball had broken the plane of the end zone.
Now remember, Oakland cannot challenge it. The booth would have to review it. That's why Norv Turner has called a timeout, so that the booth could take a look at this on three or four different replays.
See right there, ball in. See, the ball broke the plane of that goal line, so I think it's clear it was a touchdown.
The confusion after the play came when no official call had been made. The ball was already free in the Raiders.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. There's a touchdown.
Now, Solomon.
Good decisions made by Gus Frerotte, and then good running using both Ricky and Ronnie.
And the extra point from Olindo Mare, giving Miami a 14-7 lead as the rookie Brown gets his fourth rushing touchdown of the season. Left, first half. Olindo Mare to kick it off. Chris Carr is deep, standing at his own one. This is Carr. This handles it. He's going to have to take a knee. Raiders will have it at the 20. Late stages, first half. Well, coming up tonight, after 60 minutes, the answers to a family tragedy could be exposed in an old home movie. See why critics call Cold Case TV's best cop show. Don't miss a new episode right here on CBS, America's number one network.
And right now, I think if you had to ask, okay, where can the Oakland Raiders improve? I think it has to be on their third down defense. They're playing pretty solid, both sides of the ball. Have to improve in their third down execution.
Raiders have two timeouts to work with. They go conservative here with Jordan and a 5-yard gain. Fans react to that after Reggie Howard makes the stop. And they'll use one of their remaining timeouts. Stop the clock with 26 seconds remaining.
Miami.
Second and five now for the Raiders. Only 26 seconds remain, first half. Jordan in the backfield. He's got a lot of touches so far today. Here's Collins in the pocket. And Collins, wobbly throw because he was hit by Vonnie Holiday, and it's incomplete. 21 seconds remain.
Vonnie Holiday may as well be to have that presence in the mind of Kerry Collins. Even when he does have protection, he's going to anticipate pressure.
On third down, Collins will hand it to Jordan. And a spin from Jordan, and he picks up a first down out across the 30-yard line. 15 seconds remain. Oakland will use its final timeout. Highlights for you coming up at halftime.
Interesting point. Kansas City and San Diego both come away with a win. So I think it's paramount that the Raiders have to win this game to stay in the playoff game.
That Kerry Collins lost the ball. It was just sitting there, and Jake Grove, the center, able to come up with it. A flag on the play.
Offside, number 96, in the neutral zone to snap. A 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
That's David Bowen, so Raiders enter action at 4-6. And the teams that they are chasing both getting victories earlier today, and Denver getting one on Thanksgiving. Collins patting the ball, throwing underneath to Jordan. And ducks out of bounds with 5 seconds left. Now a more manageable throw for Kerry Collins because the line of scrimmage will be the 47-yard line after the 10-yard pickup.
Well, do you take a shot at the end zone? I think so, because anything can happen. And if you throw it over to Randy Moss.
Miami able to take that 14-7 lead, hoping it holds up as they go to the locker room. Here's Collins, deep drop, waiting for his receivers to get downfield. Airs it out. Collins up in the air, knocked around, and intercepted. So Tillman comes up with the pick for Miami, his third interception of the season. And that is how the first half will end. Miami 14 in the backfield. Oakland can tie it up. Handoff, Jordan up in the air for the touchdown.
Gilmore had the first quarter touchdown hitting the home run going deep. The Dolphins' defense has surprised me because they played well with the absence of Zach Thomas and Junior Seau.
Janikowski, the kick. Wes Welker returning from the fourth. Here's Welker through a lane. And Welker tackled as he crossed the 35-yard line by Stuart Schweiger on special teams.
Well, Kerry Collins, he's trying to get the ball around, trying to go downfield with it. The thing is, has to protect it, only throwing an interception on the last play of the half in that Hail Mary situation. And then Gus Frerotte, remember, he did throw the ball over on this side. That's where he was intercepted, but he's trying to get the ball down the field. They're throwing the ball downfield, and they've been successful doing so against the Oakland Raiders secondary.
Now, Miami actually came into this game with the lowest completion percentage in the NFL, the combination of Frerotte and Rosenfels, mostly, of course, Frerotte. First play from scrimmage, second half. Williams and Barnes in there. Play fake and a boot. Frerotte talks to McMichael. Catch and run for Randy McMichael. And he's forced out by Kirk Morrison, the rookie out of San Diego State. It's a 12-yard gain and a good start to this second half for Miami on offense.
They're starting to mix it up. They're mixing in the run and the pass, bringing McMichael across the formation, trying to create ways to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers. As you can see, the possessions, a touchdown in that very first possession. Then you talked about overcoming the fumble and the interception, then having to punt, but they got it together before the end of the half.
On the handoff, little spin by Ricky Williams, and he gains 5 into Oakland territory down at the 48-yard line. Remember when, you know, all the rumors were out there that Ricky Williams is coming back, wants to return to the NFL? What was the first thing that people just assumed? Oh, he's going to be a Raider.
He's a Raider. Everyone ended up playing for the Raiders. All the guys who've been disenfranchised and upset, not happy with things, everyone's supposed to end up with the Raiders. But I think it shows that coaches like Nick Saban and the organization, the Dolphins, they show forgiveness, but especially when you have the talent of Ricky Williams.
Frerotte, off play action, Chambers drops the football. Would have been a big gainer as Chambers is asking out of the game. Might have some finger issues as he heads to the sideline.
And this is a big disappointment because they expected Chris Chambers to have an excellent year. He doesn't get the head around, doesn't completely find the football. Now there's the head, So make the catch. And because it was a good throw by Gus Frerotte after getting excellent protection from the offensive line. As a receiver, you can't ask for anything more for that ball to get there very quickly.
So now a third and five for Miami. Frerotte. Look at the time. Frerotte airing it out and throwing it away. Did not have an open receiver, and he's forced to get rid of it, and Miami is forced to punt.
And if you're upset,
promising start.
Yeah, and you can't be upset with your quarterback. He did the right thing throwing it away because the play should have been made on second down. And we had talked to Nick Saban about it. He said, hey, the offensive line under the O-line coach Hudson Howe has improved. So now we need our skilled players to make the plays when the opportunity presents itself. Chris Chambers did not make the play.
Oh, oh, snap. Handled by Donnie Jones, and Chris Carr is waiting. He's going to let this one bounce. Should be saved. It is. Miami downs it at the one. Good downfield help from Jeremiah Bell. A 47-yard punt, and the Raiders are pinned back deep to open the second half. Hard providing these aerial shots of today's game here at the Coliseum, thanks to the crew of Snoopy 2. First and 10 from the one. Collins selling the play fake. And thrown down! A safety, Jason Taylor, on the sack. Collins took his time, and it cost him. Miami increases its lead.
How about the Miami defense making a play? Jason Taylor coming off the top. This is what North Turner feared. Understanding that Jason Taylor can take over a game and change the momentum. Play action fake. He gets the sack and the safety. How about the play by Taylor? No one even blocked him.
So tack on two for the Dolphins and a free kick coming. Taylor does the job for Miami on D. Critical game for the Oakland Raiders trying to stay alive in the playoff picture. They now trail 16-7. Shane Leckler, the free punt to Wes Welker. Here's Welker trying to break free. Welker crosses the 40 and is toppled down at the 44-yard line after the 22-yard return. That's where Miami will have it. Collins absorbed the sack, and it turned into 2 points for the Dolphins. Coming up tomorrow on CBS, all new, beginning with Ray Letterman here on CBS, America's number one network. On first down, handoff to Ricky Williams, breaking one tackle, and then driven down by Cooper from Oakland, 4-yard gain. Kelly in there as well for the Raiders.
And I watch how the protection breaks down on the safety play by Jason Taylor. Watch the tight end, Zaron Flemister. Like, he's going to look inside. He never blocks Jason Taylor. And then look at Lamont Jordan. He's supposed to chip, and he doesn't hit him. So they allow him to come free off the corner. No way that play is going to work if you don't pay attention to a player like Jason Taylor. You know he's coming in to get the sack.
Taylor's done a little bit of everything so far today for Miami. Deep drop. Frerotte able to get rid of it. Comebacker for Chambers. And he's able to haul it in. Going to be an 11-yard game, but a flag on the play back of the line of scrimmage. Well, Chambers was able to shake off whatever finger problems he was having.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 90, contacts at the head of the quarterback, 15-yard penalty, and a first down.
Now, it's all falling apart now for Oakland. Terdell Sands called for roughing the passer. And take a look at where they move the football now. To the 29-yard line of the Raiders.
And this is the moment that Nick Saban talked about. We met with him yesterday. He said, our players have to understand how to finish games. Mm-hmm. He said, there are moments in games where, as a player, you have to look to make a play and believe you're going to make a play. After getting the safety, and then with this kind of field position, to get a touchdown will go a long way in helping to accomplish that goal.
Quick snap on first down, slinging it out to McMichael. And a modest gainer of 7 yards. Ronaldo Hill in on coverage against the big tight end. So Miami, again, the flow has been there for them offensively, although they haven't produced huge numbers no major mistakes to speak of that has changed the tenor of this game. Of course, the Farratt interception, but it didn't cost them on the scoreboard. Handoff to Ricky Williams into a crowd, and look at the pile getting pushed forward. Ends up being a gain of four and a first down for Miami. Terdell Sands stuck his helmet in there. And a new set of downs for Miami to work with.
Oh, you focus on this situation. And as we said, I think anything less than a touchdown by Miami right now, you're still leaving the door open for Oakland. You want to take away a team's confidence because, let's face it, the Raiders have a lot riding on this game. Came in at 4-6, hoping to stay in the hunt to make the playoffs in that AFC West division.
Hand off, running crowd. And Bobby Hamilton was there to greet him. It's a loss of two on the play, setting up second and long.
Or can he still play or what? 11 years in the league and still being a productive player.
And coming up, time permitting after the game. The Subway postgame show, Greg, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer. Scores, highlights, it's all coming up on the Subway postgame show. Now, you're right about Hamilton. He's just been a workmanlike guy through the years, worked hard to get to this point in his NFL career. Second and 12, out of the gun, Farratt. Not much of a rush. Farratt steps up and throws it out of the end zone. Incomplete. Wes Welker, among those that he was looking for. It'll be third and 12.
And guess who provided the pressure? It was Hamilton. Big number 98 coming off the right corner. Otherwise, it was good protection. And he was the one lone defender getting into the backfield, forcing Farratt to throw that pass away.
So now a third and 12. Fans sensing that this is a pivotal third down. Starting to make some noise. Shotgun. High snap. Farratt handles it. Farratt under heat. Sidesteps. Throws. Same spot. This time he makes it into the Raider Nation. Derek Burgess applying the pressure.
And that counted six defenders in the end zone for the Raiders. They were not going to allow that ball to be caught in the end zone for a touchdown. And so it was the coverage that forced Farratt to throw the ball away, not necessarily the pressure on that play.
And I think a guy wearing a Mark Van Egan shirt made the catch in the second row.
Well, he was a player. he was a player now.
Field goal, 38-yarder. Murray didn't get it. Wide to the right.
Leaving the door wide open. Nick Saban wants his team to understand how to put people away. Right now, the Dolphins allow the Raiders to hang with them and stay in the game.
After the missed field goal by Mare, Raiders take over a first and 10 at the 28. Collins throwing sideline route. And a catch made by Jerry Porter. Right at the first down marker. Looks like it's going to be just short.
Porter's working that sideline, and watch the footwork. The mechanics of Collins allows him to whip that ball over there. And look at the footwork by Porter, making sure he has the catch and then the toe tap to pick up that first down. The athleticism of Porter. He's actually going to come short of the first down, but what a catch.
Second and one for the Raiders. And Jordan able to get that second effort for a first down to the 40-yard line, a gain of three. And they'll move the chains for Oakland, who just avoided a major swing on the scoreboard. Well, think about it. If Miami goes in for a touchdown there, you're looking at 23-7 Dolphins. Even a field goal extends the lead to 19-7. Raiders very much within striking distance, a lot of time left.
And important for the Raiders offense to get something going. The defense has saved them. Offense already given up 2 points in this quarter. Now you have to go out and get it back.
Lennister, the motion man. Collins had a tough time taking that snap, but he's got the protection. Knocked down! Donnie Spragan, able to get a piece of it. 6 foot, 5 inch, Kerry Collins could not get rid of it cleanly. It'll be second and 10. Tomorrow, an all-new Late Show. Don't miss Stupid Human Tricks. On second down with a three-receiver formation to the ground. Jordan keeps the legs churning and is able to cross the 45 for a gain of five. Randy Moss, Solomon, one catch, 18 yards so far for the Raiders.
And if you're the Miami Dolphins secondary, that's the way you like it. Now, I don't think he's 100%, and I think it's tough for a player like him to play when he's not 100% and able to run full speed and get down the field, because speed is so much a part of his game. And I think without it, you know, he's just like a lot of other players.
Third and a short five now for Oakland. Can they keep this drive going? Collins throwing, flag down, intercepted by Jeremiah Bell. He was looking for Courtney Anderson, the tight end. But a penalty marker on the play. We'll see if Bell got an advantage on a push-off.
Yeah, Bell made contact with Courtney Anderson. Anderson went to the ground.
Defense, number 37. Penalized at the spot of the foul and a first down.
Watch the play. Jeremiah Bell matched up against Courtney Anderson. And there's going to be contact as they come into our frame. You see Anderson going down. There it is. He trips. I don't know if the contact was necessarily initiated by Jeremiah Bell, but there was contact.
Now it's a 19-yard penalty and gives Oakland a shot. Pump fake, throw, catch, touchdown! Doug Gabriel! And a flag on the play. Sam Madison pointing that Gabriel was out of bounds.
And the flag went up because there was some arm fighting on the play between Gabriel and Madison.
And that's what they're sorting out right now. Gabriel matched up with a veteran Pro Bowler, Sam Madison.
Illegal touching on a forward pass. Number 87 stepped out of bounds. Came back in bounds and was the first to touch the pass. A 5-yard penalty.
Well,
repeat first down.
Yeah, that's wrong number, I believe, unless Witt had got a piece of it and we didn't see it.
Yeah, we definitely didn't see that. Great protection this time. Look, the double pump, then the throw by Collins is on the money. Now, maybe they're saying that Gabriel stepped out of bounds. Mm-hmm. You see the official throw the hat down. That means, yes, he stepped out of bounds, and the official is marking where he actually went out of bounds. And so the hat coming off would signify that Doug Gabriel stepped out of bounds before coming back in to make that catch.
And that's exactly what Madison was telling the officials after the catch was made. And the Raiders accept it. First and 15. The rush and the throw. Porter unable to haul it in with Kevin Carter, who had a clean look at Kerry Collins. Time for an NFL Today update. To New York, Greg Gumbel.
All right.
All right, thanks very much, Greg. Jacksonville with Leftwich going down early in that game. David Garrard coming in to replace him. Try to add to their 7-3 record. Collins looking for the big hit. And it's incomplete. Randy Moss was along the sideline, and he is staring down the official with Travis Daniels, the rookie, in coverage.
And Daniels just does a good job of staying on top. But you see, Moss doesn't have the explosion to go by defenders like what we're used to seeing. We give Daniels credit for staying in front of Moss, keeping the position, getting the head around, and making a play.
Daniels, who played for Saban at LSU, taken in the fourth round, and dealing with a future Hall of Famer in Randy Moss today. Third and 15 now for Oakland. And a touchdown denied because Gabriel had stepped out of bounds. Collins guns. On a crossing route, Gabriel. First down, Oakland, inside the 20-yard line. 23-yard pass play as Gabriel does some talking after the tackle.
And a huge third down play for the Raiders. The protection holds up, and Collins, when he gets time, he delivers a strike. Receivers haven't been completely reliable today, but on this one, Gabriel's very reliable, making the catch, coming over the middle of the defense. Knows he's going to take a lick, but watch him hold on to the ball and continue to fight for extra yards.
And a first and 10 now at the Miami 16 for Oakland. Here's Collins in the pocket, stepping forward. Collins looking to tuck and run. And able to turn his body to absorb the hit of Reggie Howard. And he picks up 5 yards. Kerry Collins, not known for his scrambling ability.
But Collins is battling. You know, he hasn't played an overwhelmingly great football game today. He's been somewhat inconsistent, but at times he's been able to deliver some strikes, and then the receivers have failed. But right now find themselves an opportunity to get inside that red zone once again today and then turn it into a touchdown.
A lumbering run by Collins. Good for 5 yards and a second and five. Handoff to Jordan. And Jordan driven back after he hit the hole. We'll give him forward progress for a pickup of four. Channing Crowder able to move him in the other direction. And Crowder, a guy Nick Saban told us, look, he belongs inside. Obviously, he's not going to play ahead of a healthy Zach Thomas, but that's where we see him at this level.
Oh, they feel it's his natural position. He's so talented, and you talk to the coaches and say he's very bright. Did play that inside linebacker position at the University of Florida, so he's more of a natural inside linebacker. I think there's a learning curve there. No way he's going to be able to do the things that Zach Thomas was able to do over his 10-year career.
Third and one. Handoff. Jordan busting three. Touchdown, Oakland. Lamont Jordan with a jolt to the end zone, and Oakland draws closer.
Young linebackers tend to get nosy. Watch the cutback. See, they over-pursue the ball, and then you cut it back. Lamont Jordan sensing the aggressive nature of those young linebackers for the Dolphins and find a hole through the back door.
Extra point, Janikowski, a 10-play, 72-yard drive for the Oakland Raiders. Miami unable to cash in on the other end with a field goal attempt, and the Raiders come right back to put seven on the board. 16-14, Miami. Rushing touchdown of the day for Lamont Jordan. That one covered 8 yards and brought the Oakland Raiders to within two of the Dolphins, 16-14. Miami has posted five straight regular season wins over the Raiders. And the kickoff, Janikowski to Welker. And Welker goes down in a heap out across the 20. Randall Williams down there along with Brayton for Oakland. We'll come back. Third quarter action continues. The NFL on CBS. Raiders Nation alive and well. Apparently they do allow nachos in Raiders Nation. I never knew that until today. First and 10 for the Dolphins. Here is Farrakh throwing wide open. Chris Chambers cuts it back. And Chambers will be brought down out near the 42-yard line. And that will quiet the crowd after the 22-yard hookup.
And it's what Gus Frerotte told us he wanted to do, is to get the ball in the hands of his receivers with room to make a move. And look at Chambers putting the move on the defensive back. That's going to be Fabian Washington, and still able to make some yards after making the catch. I thought that Gus Frerotte moved well in the pocket, bought himself some time to make that completion.
On first down, handoff, Ronnie Brown. And Brown able to work himself for a 4-yard gain. Ronaldo Hill helping in run support, as he is wont to do in this defensive alignment. Coming up tomorrow on CBS, a member of the CSI team gets busted. CBS, 39 yards for Ronnie Brown. Does have the rushing touchdown today. And a second and six now for the Dolphins. Raiders crowd the line. Here they come. Farrakh gets rid of it. Lorenzo Diamond back up tight end, hit by Hill, 3-yard gain, short of a first down, and it will be third down and a couple.
Oh, it's a combination of pressure and coverage. They send the blitz after Farrakh, knowing that he's going to go to Diamond on the hot read. It's a three-step drop. You get it out there. Hill does an excellent job of knowing the ball's coming out quick, making the tackle, and don't allow the catch and the run for a first down.
At midfield, a third and three for Miami. Under 4 minutes to go in this third quarter. Shotgun, shovel, Brown mishandled it initially, and he's got a first down. Good piece of running by Ronnie Brown. A 7-yard gain.
Good piece of concentration. Watch how they flip the ball out to him. Now, see, he didn't handle it initially, then regained possession of that ball, still able to run forward, pick up the first down. Good blocking out front by the receivers and the guards pulling out to create room for that first down.
He's gotten 12 touches in the running game. Williams has gotten 8. And into Oakland territory, first and 10. Tarot avoids the pressure, hits his man Brown, and another first down for the Dolphins. He is chased down by Tyler Brayton at a 15-yard pass and catch.
And now you see why he was the second player taken in the draft. We saw him run the ball around the goal line. We see him doing a lot of different things in his offense, but his ability to catch the ball out of the backfield, with Nick Saban said, here's a guy that does a lot of things very well in terms of his versatility and a pretty good blocker in pass protection.
Down to 2:37 left in this third quarter. Handoff. It's Brown, stiff arm, and dragged down by Brayton. So Ronnie Brown is going to pick up 3 for Miami. Wednesday on CBS, it's the most twisted episode. Brown now, 13 carries, 49 yards, and the touchdown. Second and 7. We hit the 2-minute mark, third quarter. Ricky Williams is in there for the Dolphins. Tarot comes. Wide open. McMichael is in for the touchdown. Able to sidestep Schweiger and take it the distance for the Dolphins.
And this is why you want to get the ball into the hands of your weapons with room to run, because yards after the catch come at a premium. But if you can get the ball in the hands of an athlete like Randy McMichael in the open field, he can make guys miss. And so Farad, he sees him right away. See, he is eyeballing him right away. Get it to him quick. Now watch the move on Stuart Schweiger. From then on, it's an easy walk into the end zone for Randy McMichael.
Extra point, Mare. 7 plays, 79 yards. How's that for an answer from Miami?
Really good answer. Now, this play was designed to go to McMichael from the beginning. Yeah, he looks him off, comes down. It's just a slow read sitting down in the zone. And he understood. He just had to beat the safety, Schweiger, to get it in for a touchdown. But it was a good mix of run and pass on that possession by the Miami Dolphins. An excellent answer to that drive by the Raiders.
Fourth catch of the day, 59 yards for the tight end. And first touchdown through the air for McMichael. Second of the day for Farad as we head to New York. Another up.
Those young players that we talked about that's helping this defense to improve. Had an excellent first half where he forced a fumble, recovered a fumble, even had an interception down the red zone. But I think if you were to talk to Stuart Schweiger, we enjoyed speaking with him yesterday, tell you, hey, he has to make that play in the open field, has to improve on his tackling.
So Miami with a 23-14 advantage now. Mare, the kick. Here's Carr from the 2. He's quick. Carr through a hole. Chris Carr trying to bust it to the outside. He's got speed. And Carr finally forced to the sideline by Reggie Howard.
I'll say he has speed. He's able to start and stop and still up to full speed after a couple of steps.
And a 55-yard return for Carr.
Well, really good run. It's a good read. As you see, take it here, and it's just Kirk busting it up the middle. Watch the start and stop. And then the acceleration pass to Lindo Mari and taking it over to the other side. But he gives the Raider excellent field position. Now they have an opportunity to answer the Dolphins' touchdown.
Line of scrimmage is the 43 of Miami. We are late in the third quarter. Collins is sacked. Jason Taylor got him by the ankles, and it was enough to bring down Kerry Collins.
Oh, Barry Sims is just having a nightmare right now because he can't keep him out. You see, he's working down here right at the bottom. Watch 65. Sims stops him initially, but then one move up and under, and they just push him right down at the feet of the quarterback. Jason Taylor having a field day with this Oakland Raider offense.
It might be a half sack for Brad Badger, the left guard.
Well, he can go over and thanks Brad. Thank you to Brad.
It gave a little shove, thought he was doing the right thing towards the ground. It just happened to be at the feet of Collins. And here's Collins stepping and throwing, and lucky it wasn't picked off. Randy Moss was in the area. Travaris Tillman had the opportunity to come up with the INT. Channing Crowder applied that pressure on Collins. Coming up tonight, 60 Minutes. What's the biggest thing in home sales? It's the CBS, America's number one network. Third and 18. Dolphins looking to pin their ears back, and this play is whistled dead. Miami got a lot of players to the line of scrimmage, and Oakland may have jumped. Ron Winter will get the number and pass along the information to us and to you at home as well.
But he's going to take a while before he do it.
He'll take his time.
False start. Offense number 70. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
So the false start in what really should have been a drive for Oakland to make a statement to get back into the game after the field position they were given by the Chris Carr return has really fallen apart on them. Third and 23. And a shotgun for Collins. And another flag. Oakland has been whistled for 9 penalties today.
False start. Offense number 85. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
And that's Doug Gabriel. That's penalty number 10 against North Turner's club.
And Gabriel's been called a couple of times now for a false start. And had to be taken out and replaced by Alvis Whitted in the second quarter of this game.
Now, Jason Taylor had dropped back into coverage, and Gabriel then reacted because he didn't expect to see it from Taylor. Miami is giving them a couple of different looks here, and now they'll back off again. Shotgun, Collins. Here's the rush. Collins throws. Incomplete. Kerry Porter was surrounded by white jerseys. Late flag. They just threw the flag. The whistle had blown. You could hear the crowd building.
Yeah. And that's because they expected a flag. There were 7 players who dropped into coverage for the Miami Dolphins. Sensing a throw down the field on third and long, you get 7 into coverage, you'd think you'd be able to break it out
right
without making contact.
Pass interference. Defense number 37. Penalized at the spot of the foul.
Oh, goodness, man.
And a first down.
Jeremiah Bell on a third and 28, Solomon.
And watch Bell. And the ball isn't even thrown well. Now, this ball just fluttered in midair. Why would you come and hit the receiver?
Yep.
The ball is going to go right into the ground. You just have to have, I think, greater poise. And I think Nick Saban saying, hey, he wasn't going to catch that ball anyway because it fell short of the receiver. But he has to be hot with Jeremiah Bell, his own player, for not really executing the play.
A 26-yard penalty and a handoff to Jordan. And Jordan is able to carry to the 30-yard line for a 5-yard pickup.
And we talk about the Dolphins not being able to finish off the opponent. After the safety, they had a possession in the red zone of the Oakland Raiders, and they missed the field goal. And now on third and long, you have an opportunity to get off the field, get the ball back for your offense. Jeremiah Bell commits the penalty, and now you give the Raiders another shot to stay in the game.
On a 2nd and 5, down to 25 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Collins, play fake, rush, Collins, the safety valve, Jordan. And he had more yards in front of him, stumbling down, but he picks up 9.
Got a little anxious, but he still was able to make the catch and move the chains.
And that's going to be it for this third quarter. We will head to the fourth. Oakland is on the move. A penalty kept their drive alive. NFL on CBS live from Oakland. McAfee Coliseum, start of the fourth quarter. Ian Eagle, Solomon Wilcots, our entire CBS crew with Miami in front. 23-14. Dolphins trying to snap a 3-game losing streak. They've dropped 6 of their last 7. Oakland trying to get themselves back into it. First play of the fourth. And it's a 1st and 10 for the Raiders. Collins in the pocket, throwing underneath to Zach Crockett. And he'll pick up a few yards. Derek Pope, the linebacker, making the play. NFL Today, in case you missed it earlier, Boomer Esiason thinks the Chargers could go 10-6, but may not be enough to get them into the playoffs. Who's the 2nd best team in the NFL? If we're all assuming Indianapolis is number 1 because they're undefeated. Well, Seattle is a team that's come up in conversation. I know Dan Marino had tossed out the Seahawks as a possibility.
Yeah, and I think Boomer made a really good point about San Diego going 10-6 and possibly not making the playoffs. That could happen in the AFC. It happened last year. You know it could happen because there's some very good teams on that side.
Play clock winding down. Collins gets the playoff on second down. Collins steps up and throws. Incomplete. Jerry Porter got his hands on it. It'll be third down for Oakland.
They had an opportunity. They took a shot. Kerry Collins liked what he saw as Porter came across the formation deep in the end zone. Let's see if he had a chance right through the mittens. Two hands touched the ball. If you're a receiver, you got to come down with it. Good throw. Poor execution on the other end by Jerry Porter. Ball went right through his hands and should have been a touchdown.
His second drop of the day, coming off one of his best games as a pro last week. On third down, Collins steps up. Collins trying to run. Kerry Collins sliding down for the touchdown. Who is that man?
Is that Michael Vick? It's Kerry Collins doing the unexpected. And the pressure has harassed him all day. And finally, when it breaks down, the coverage turns its back to the quarterback. They never see him coming. He's able to walk and slide into the end zone. Excellent play. Watch, the pressure gets upfield. And now the coverage, they're in man coverage. They have their back to the quarterback. They don't see him coming by the time they get turned around and are able to react. He's in for a touchdown.
His longest run on the season was 8 yards. That one covered 18 yards as Janikowski nails the extra point. Well, we knew coming in, Oakland had a number of breakaway threats on their offense. We just didn't know that number five was one of those guys until now. Questionable pass interference penalty on Jeremiah Bell kept the drive alive for Oakland. And then Kerry Collins, an 18-yard rushing touchdown, bringing the Raiders to within 23-21. Return man, Wes Welker. Oh, they got him. Raiders get down the field with Tim Johnson leading the charge. And it's short of the 20-yard line. Coming up, time permitting after the game. Certainly a different feeling inside the Coliseum now, as the pressure is back on Miami. Even though they lead it 23-21, Farrakh. Able to throw, Alex Holmes, the rookie from USC. And a 2-yard gain, his first catch as a pro.
Have to be able to make the tackles for this Oakland Raiders defense.
On a second and 8. Double tight end set. Hand the ball off to Ronnie Brown. And into a crowd. Ted Washington, the mammoth nose tackle, helping to make the stop. A 4-yard gain. Washington is a mountain of a man at 6'5".
The line getting up the field, trying to put pressure on Gus Farrakh. And you know they're going to come after him. Let's see how he responds. He's able to get the ball down the field.
This is a 3rd and 4. Chambers goes in motion. Here comes the rush. Flag down. Farrakh, free play. It's incomplete. He was looking for McMichael. Looked like the left side of the Oakland defense may have gotten a jump and offsides. DeLawrence Grant, number 59, was over there.
Offside. Defense number 59. 5-yard penalty. That results in a first down.
And a mistake for the Raiders on defense, which would have forced Miami to punt.
And as a coach, you don't want to give them anything. And that's exactly what DeLawrence Grant did by jumping offsides. You essentially give the Miami Dolphins a new set of downs, time to take time off the clock when you do that. And so you have to make them earn it all. Right now, you're being way too generous.
1st and 10 now from the 30. Handoff. It's Chambers getting the opportunity and able to get a 5-yard pickup. Asamoua able to make that stop from his cornerback position for Chambers.
His needs for his players to make plays in the open field.
Scott Linehan, offensive coordinator, who's been under some fire in Miami during this losing skid. Play action. Farrakh steps up. Farrakh throwing over the middle to Ronnie Brown. Good hands. And a first down for Miami out across the 40-yard line. Danny Clark, middle linebacker, makes the tackle.
Right now, Gus Farrakh is hitting that level.
Six straight completions for Farrakh. Fake the handoff. Farrakh throwing incomplete. It was Ronnie Brown who released out of the backfield and would not have been much of a gainer because of the coverage from Oakland. Inside today in place of Warren Sapp, placed on injured reserve yesterday. So the medical staff will
did.
Miami 23, Oakland 21. 11 minutes to go in this fourth quarter. Dump off for Ricky Williams. And he is spilled out near midfield. Ronaldo Hill on that stop. And a 5-yard gain through the air for Miami.
5-yard gain sets up maybe a third and six, a third and five, somewhere in that area. For the Dolphins in a big time third down play where they have to be able to advance the drive. But if you're the Raiders, you got to get a stop. You got to get a stop and get the ball back for your offense.
Farrakh, third and five, working out of the shotgun. Four receivers for Farrakh to work with. He's got pressure from behind and sacked. Derek Burgess. He has been Mr. Sack for Oakland this season. That's number 11 for Burgess. And it puts an end to the drive for Miami.
And Burgess is the guy. He closes out the deal. You'll see him coming off the top right here. Now, he gets away initially. Gus Farrakh does. But watch the speed, the burst of Derek Burgess. Able to run him down and trip him up for a huge sack on third down.
And the punt from Donnie Jones. Carr will let this one bounce. Oh, what a kick by Jones. Miami able to touch it up inside the five. Travis Minor getting downfield. Second sack of the day for Burgess in a two-point game. View of McAfee Coliseum, where the Miami Dolphins lead the Raiders 23-21. Oakland, last time they were back deep in their own territory. Kerry Collins took a safety in the end zone. The sack by Taylor. Handoff to Jordan, bouncing it to the outside. He's got some room. Jordan down the sideline. And scampers out of bounds. Good block by Flemister this time. And Jordan with a 26-yard burst for Oakland. 9 weeks into the TV season, only one team remains undefeated. Number one network. Longest run of the season for Lamont Jordan. And it gives Oakland some breathing room. Play action. Collins, flag down, throw. Good catch made by Jordan. One-handed stab at a penalty marker. And it looks like holding right in that area that Kerry Collins was setting himself in the pocket.
Holding. Offense number 76. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Now that's Robert Gallery, and that's another penalty on Oakland. Let's head to New York. Greg Gumbel.
All right, Ian, at Arizona.
All right, thanks very much, Greg. It's looking good for Jacksonville. Trying to move to 8-3. 12th penalty of the day for Oakland. Collins able to get rid of it. And this time Jordan is unable to hold on. Reggie Howard on that corner blitz against Kerry Collins.
And the Miami Dolphins trying to pick their spots. When to come after the quarterback, Kerry Collins. Right now, I think they have to focus on Lamont Jordan because whenever he's getting the ball, he's starting to crease this defense, whether it's running it or catching the ball out of the backfield.
And worth mentioning again, Randy Moss, one catch today, 18 yards. Just off the top of my head, I remember maybe three balls being thrown in his direction. Second and 20. There's Collins stepping up. Collins flutters one with a flag down. It's fielded like a punt by Sam Madison. And Madison is out of bounds. Penalty marker. Madison is first pick of the season. And let's see what this flag is against Miami. That's the early indication.
Sam Madison hadn't had a pick in his last 31 ball games, so he's hoping that the flag isn't against the Miami Dolphins.
Before the pass is thrown, illegal use of hands to the face, defense number 21, a 5-yard penalty, and a first down.
Wow. Travis Daniels, the rookie, and the second straight drive where a penalty has just killed Miami.
And it's the thing that allows the Raiders to stay in the ballgame. Has to be very frustrating for Nick Saban because he sees his football team playing well at times, enough to win this game, but then seeing the mistakes that's allowing the opponent to hang around.
And a first and 10 now from the 25 for Collins and the Raiders. Long catch for Collins. Steps up and guns to Moss. That's a short gainer for Randy Moss. Only a 3-yard pickup through the air. You just don't think Moss is himself physically right now?
I really don't think he is. I don't see the burst, the explosion that you need, and especially the explosion you're used to seeing from him. Now, his presence on the field, I think, does a lot.
Sure.
That's the reason why you're seeing Gabriel get opportunities to catch the ball, Porter, even the check down to Lamont Jordan, because he attracts so much attention in double coverage, he allows others to get open.
On second down, in the pocket, Collins slings it over the middle to Moss. And now Moss is getting involved. The forward progress is going to take him right at the first down line for a gain of 7. Reggie Howard with coverage. And it is enough to move the chains for Oakland.
Well, that's a rare sighting. Randy Moss catching the ball over the middle.
Yeah, almost
taking a shot.
Had to catch myself when I said it.
He was over the middle. And so showing us some different things. And you know, when you talk to many of the players, even Gus Frerotte talked about him because they played together in Minnesota. He said, hey, he was an excellent teammate to have. Didn't agree with all the things he did. He said, but he's the kind of guy you'll tolerate some things because he'll make big plays.
Handoff running directly through the middle, Lamont Jordan. And he picks up 4 yards. Donnie Spragan will be given credit for the stop for Miami. And for those of you expecting to see 60 Minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS. The Miami Dolphins and the Oakland Raiders. Ian Eagle, Solomon Wilcots. Our score, Miami, with a 23-21 lead on the Raiders. 60 Minutes will be seen in its entirety immediately following this game, except on the West Coast. Jordan inching closer to the 100-yard mark. He's got a pair of touchdown runs. This is a 2nd and 5. Collins has the time, able to set and throw to Courtney Anderson. And it's 2 yards shy of the first down. Donnie Spragan able to bring him down. It's going to set up 3rd and short for Oakland.
Well, it was a good tackle by Spragan. He was tight in coverage, but was on the wrong side when the completion was made, but made sure Anderson did not pick up 1 extra yard after the catch, able to drive him out of the bounds. So it's a good coverage, good tackle. Now the defense has to hold up.
Let's call it 3rd and a long 1 for Oakland. Trailing by 2. Play fake. Collins on the move. Too high! He had Porter open for a 1st down. And with 6.5 to go in the 4th, Oakland facing a 4th down.
Huge play. And that's why if you're Spragan on 3rd down, or excuse me, on the previous 2nd down, you have to make the tackle, because as they roll out, watch, you're going to see Porter wide open. The pressure in the face of the quarterback forces Kerry Collins to overthrow Jerry Porter.
Wasted opportunity to keep this drive going and get into field goal range. Instead, Shane Leckler, who has not had a good day by his standards, or by any punter's standards, booting the ball away. Take a roll. Oh, very close to hovering around the goal line. It's a 56-yard punt, but a net of 36. 4th quarter action continues the NFL on CBS. Important game here for the Oakland Raiders. Just trying to stay in the conversation in terms of playoff talk in the AFC at 4-6. Dolphins at 3-7. Miami 1st and 10 from the 20. Frerotte fires incomplete for Chambers in a matchup with a rookie Washington. It'll be 2nd and 10, Dolphins.
Well, Remember, the Dolphins begin this game picking on the rookie cornerback Fabian Washington, beating him for their first touchdown of the game, deciding to go back there. But Ferrat now has to show that he can lead the offense and try to put this game away. You see Nick Saban working the officials, trying to get that extra call.
Second and 10. Williams is back there for Miami. Hand off, it's Ricky Williams. And he's able to carry to the 26. 6-yard gain. Jared Cooper combining with Bobby Hamilton to bring him down. NFL Today update. Down to the wire there. He might be facing the same situation here. Miami 23, Oakland 21. Under 6 minutes to go now on a 3rd and 4 for the Dolphins. Operating out of the gun. Ferrat throwing out across to Chambers and turns it upfield for a big gain. He was out of bounds at the 50. But he was able to get a reception. And he has cracked the century mark. 101 yards on 6 catches. And a huge third down reception. Handoff to Ricky Williams. And Williams able to keep his legs moving for a 6-yard gain. And we hit 5 minutes to play in this fourth quarter. For those of you expecting to see 60 Minutes, this is the NFL on CBS. 60 Minutes will be shown in its entirety immediately following our coverage, except on the West Coast. Each team with all of their timeouts still on the board. And a 2nd and 4 for Miami. In a misdirection, it's Williams, first man through. And Ricky Williams has a first down. Rex Hadnott, the right guard, with a good block up front. That's a 7-yard gain for Williams.
Nice run by Ricky Williams. You could see the explosion and the power coming back to his game.
And an injury out on the field. It will be Hadnott, the second-year right guard out of Houston. From who steps in his third year from Alabama. First down, Miami. Williams in the backfield for the Dolphins. He'll get the call. Here's Ricky Williams up the gut. And a 3-yard gain for Williams. Pushing and shoving after the play. Ted Washington in the middle of it.
Dolphins continue to eat time off the clock. And they have been able to run the ball with Ricky Williams on this possession. Of their 6 plays, 4 of them have been runs.
Oakland uses a timeout. They still have 2 remaining. 3:57 to play now in this fourth quarter. You know, Nick Saban, we talked a great deal about what this week has been like for him with the statements following the shutout loss to Cleveland. And he, you know, mentioned to us trying to build that identity. When you're a new head coach, that's what you're trying to get through to your players. And he, again, reiterated it's not about how many games they have left on the schedule, how many wins they necessarily finish with. It's about doing the things they need to do to improve and then turn the corner as an organization.
If you're going to build something, I think that's lasting, particularly or in one season. But he understands that if we do it the right way, when we get it turned around, it's going to be that way for a lasting period of time.
He's also got a 5-year contract, which helps. Big hole. It's Williams. Ricky Williams to daylight for the touchdown. 34-yard rip. And just like that, Miami increases its lead.
And this is the Ricky of old. You think they're glad to have him back on the team now? I think so. Watch how they run it downhill. And he explodes. And we talked about tackling on this drive by the Oakland Raiders defense. If they were going to hold up, they would have to tackle well. Poor tackling results in a touchdown for the Miami Dolphins.
2nd touchdown of the season for Ricky Williams. And his longest run of the year, 34 yards. Miami an extra point away from taking a 30-21 lead. And you have to go back to the 3rd down throw. Kerry Collins over the head of Jerry Porter, which would have kept the drive going if he completes it and would have changed the entire complexion of this fourth quarter.
And this could be the run to end the Raiders' hopes of making the playoffs. They block down and kick out on the end, and then the speed of Ricky Williams. It's back. It's apparent he's much slimmer in this second time around, but still has that speed and explosive nature that you're used to seeing from Ricky Williams.
Well, the disappointment of a week ago, the first time they were shut out in 29 straight games, a 22-0 loss in Cleveland, which I think is safe to say the low point of the season for Miami, an embarrassing defeat. And now you see,
we're going to make a step toward the playoffs. It has to start this week. It's obvious they got off to the slow start. Miami came in here prepared to play.
Yep. And Orlando Mari on a kickoff. Chris Carr to return it. No, he'll take a knee. And the Raiders will have it at the 20. Coming up tonight. Now defensively, you see a lot of frustration. And it looked like it bubbled over along that sideline. North Turner was telling his guys, come on. There's still 3:50 left on this clock. And it's a 9-point deficit. Collins, hand in his face, flagged down, somehow complete to Courtney Anderson. As Vonnie Holiday got into the grill of Kerry Collins. And a 4-yard gain, penalty marker.
Holding. Offense number 70. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Now that's penalty number 13 for Brad Badger.
Collins, has it been an easy task?
So now first and 20 as they back it up to the 10-yard line. Oakland looking to throw it here with Collins. And out of bounds. He was hit by Sam Madison, a 15-yard gain. Well, the Raiders have a lot to do and not a lot of time to do it.
Yeah, but in 3 minutes and 35 seconds, you still have the two-minute warning. You have to have a sense of urgency on offense that, and the belief that you can take the ball down the field and score a touchdown and then possibly get an onside kick that would help you win the game. You can't argue amongst teammates on the sideline. When there's time on the clock, you still have an opportunity to make things happen.
On a second and 5, Collins, rush coming, and intercepted. Say goodnight. Lance Schulter is tripped up, and that should do it.
Okay, now you can talk about it.
Well,
because that should do it. Good play by Lance Schulter, and a poor mistake by Kerry Collins.
Well, now the Oakland offense can actually get involved in the conversation along the sideline.
The what happened conversation, what did happen is Collins has his eye on the receiver the whole way. This ball just flutters. I think he was trying to get the ball over to Gabriel coming across the formation, but Schulters had a position in front of the receiver able to make that interception.
Now for Kerry Collins, his second pick of the day. Miami now takes over with 3:25 to go and a 30-21 lead. And a timeout called. Oakland will have one remaining. Lance Schulte, San Diego, and you got Kansas City very much in the hunt in the AFC. Ronnie Brown, he fumbles the ball. Ronnie Brown has coughed it up for the second time today, and Oakland gets it back. A go figure.
Well, you don't want us to get back in it.
Stuart Schweigert is the injured Raider, and they're going to try to help him up. They're looking at that left leg, lower leg area. Schweigert, who has matured in his second year and has shown
Ronnie Brown got to protect the ball. We talk about young runners understanding the situation. See, he's hit by Jarrett Cooper, number 40. But young runners need to understand, do I fight for that extra yard? Well, if I'm near the first down marker. But if we have a lead in the fourth quarter in the final minutes of the
games, you got a bunch of other teams in the hunt in the NFC. So the Raiders get it back for the first and 10 from the 16. Airing it out. Home run ball. Incomplete. Doug Gabriel, double coverage. It'll be second and 10 for Oakland. Tillman and Madison. We're back there.
You know North Turner is going to take some shots, getting the ball down the field, and it's Gabriel matched up on the outside, and the ball's just overthrown. You see the safety coming over the top, so they understand what the Raiders have to do in order to get back in it.
So a second and 10 now for the Raiders, trailing 30-21. There's Collins throwing, popped up, and picked off. It came off of Porter and fell to Lance Shulters. Another INT for Shulters. That's number 4 on the season. And Jerry Porter has had a rough day for Oakland. Penalty marker on the play.
Prior to the pass, holding, defense number 52. 5-yard penalty and a first down.
Now, Miami, if the Raiders could just make a play, because the Dolphins have given them opportunities to do so.
Line of scrimmage is now the 21 and a first and 10 for Oakland. There's Collins. Pocket is collapsing and loses the ball. Intercepted. How about Jason Taylor and the all-around ability that he brings to the field?
You know, often we say it's all about who wants it the most. This may be about who wants it the least, because the ball just continues to go back and forth between both teams. Look at the pressure hit from the blind side. The ball comes out while the arm is behind the head of Kerry Collins.
Well, they're going to call it a sack and a fumble as Collins lost the ball. David Bowens applied the hit, and it popped free to Taylor. And that should do it with 2:56 to go. Ricky Williams, he's in there and he's going to hold on to the football. He's brought down after a gain of 2. Oakland has one timeout remaining and the 2-minute warning. They'll use their timeout with 2:45 left. And for Kerry Collins, he told us yesterday there's a huge difference between being 4-7 and 5-6. Unfortunately, he and the Raiders are going to experience that feeling of being 4-7.
You know, when they watch the game tape, they're going to be, I think, sorely disappointed in their performance today, because they're going to see the fact that they had opportunities to win. They're going to see that, yeah, if we would have just taken care of our business with the turnovers, the safeties allowed, and then the drop balls and plays not made, I think they're going to be sick to their stomachs when they see that they really could have won this game. It could be a mention in the playoff race.
Now, as for Miami, they'll be home for Buffalo next week and see if they can use this win to finish their season strong as the Dolphins look to improve to 4-7. This is a 2nd-and-8. And here's Williams. And again, protecting the football as all those black jerseys come firing through, and Jared Cooper actually came out of the pile with it, but the play was whistled dead. A gain of 1.5. Remaining games for Nick Saban and company. Buffalo, then at San Diego, so another trip to the West Coast. The Jets, Tennessee, and then finishing off the season on New Year's Day at New England.
Now, if you know Nick Saban, you know he's going to keep his team competitive and they're going to continue to play hard. That's why last week's game was so shocking.
Yep, agreed. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in Oakland. We'll come back to the Coliseum in a moment. 2 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter. And the Oakland Raiders trailing the Miami Dolphins 30-21. Dolphins have 5 straight regular season wins over the Raiders. Handoff goes to Ricky Williams, and able to pound his way to the 10-yard line for Miami. Coming up tonight here on CBS, 60 Minutes, followed by a new episode of Cold Case in the Hallmark Hall of Fame movie, Silver Bells. It's all tonight, and it's all on America's number one network, CBS. Alindo Mari on for a field goal. Missed one earlier, which is one of the reasons why the door was still open for the Oakland Raiders. This is a 27-yard attempt. Mari missed one from 38 yards away. Miami's going to use a timeout. Well, Mari on the season is now 14 of 18 on field goal attempts. with a long of 53, now in his ninth year in a Dolphin uniform. So a timeout taken. Nick Saban. This Miami team just trying to learn how to play right in Saban's mind, and that's going to lead to victories.
And you know he'll use some of the moments in this game to show that, hey, guys, you could have put it away sooner, but they're going to be happy. I mean, he tried to do everything right coming out here to the West Coast. You know, he said, hey, we studied on how to prepare coming out here, bringing our team out to make sure that we're prepared to play.
27-yard field goal is good for Mare. And Miami, in the absence of Zach Thomas, who knows how serious that injury is, and, you know, it's our understanding, it's not even the shoulder anymore. He could probably play, or would be willing to play with a harness, but it's more that high ankle sprain that's plaguing him. Junior Seau, the assumption is that that's the last time you'll see him in a Miami uniform, as Seau just wrapped up his 16th NFL season at the age of 36, and Nick Saban looking probably to move forward. He's got young linebackers, so maybe Seau gets another one-year deal from a team that's willing to give him a shot in training camp at the veterans minimum. We'll see what happens with Seau, who has now missed, if you include all the games he'll miss this season, 17 games over the last 2 years, after missing just 9 in his first 13 seasons in the NFL. Season is over because of that Achilles tendon injury. But Seau's come out and said, hey, I'm not considering retirement. I will play again.
And I'm not going to write him off.
Yeah,
I've seen him play good football over the years, and you know he has the heart of a champion. And I think taking the rest of the season off to heal, not just that Achilles tendon, but even other parts of the body, and then to get into shape as he goes into training camp, whether it's with the Miami Dolphins or with some other team. You know, with the knowledge and the work ethic that he brings and the leadership, he'll be able to fit in somewhere. I think it's just finding the right fit where he'll be able to help a football team out.
Mare on the kickoff. Chris Carr moves forward to catch it at the 5. Carr nearly broke one earlier. And this time he's ridden down as he crossed the 25-yard line for Oakland. The executive producers of the NFL on CBS, Sean McManus and Tony Battiti. Today's game produced by Bob Dekus, directed by Kathy Barreto. Senior producer of CBS Sports and the NFL Today, Eric Mann. The director, Bob Matina. Coordinating producer of CBS Sports, Harold Bryant. The associate directors of today's game, Corey Fishman and Sarah Rinaldi. Broadcast associate, Julie Landa. Technical manager, Steve McCune. Technical director, Colby Bourgeois. And the audio supervisor, Phil Adler. Collins throwing out across the middle to Courtney Anderson. And Anderson's got a first down at the 40-yard line. It covers 12 yards. Now only 52 seconds left for Oakland. And everything that they talked about was predicated on getting this win. Then maybe the serious conversations could take place. And Channing Crowder, he's in some pain. I wonder if it was a stinger or something that gave him that quick jolt of pain.
I'm glad to see he's okay.
Yep.
Because he's a talented young football player. He is going to have a long future with the Miami Dolphins.
Well, when he was healthy at Florida, he was dominant. Now, that was the issue, though, was staying on the field, and he leaves after his sophomore year. And probably the reason why he was available in the third round for the Miami Dolphins, it could turn out to be one of the real steals of the 2005 NFL draft. Stiff arm from Jordan and then ducks out of bounds with 37 seconds left. So at this point, the Raiders offensive players just padding their stats. A 4. Final 35 seconds. Collins to the outside. Anderson stays in bounds, and only 28 seconds remain. Sam Madison with the hit. Able to bring him down as the two got tied up.
Is that what you call it?
I don't know. What would you call it?
I would say that Sam Madison would not get up.
Okay.
He wants to Take some time off the clock.
That's a fair assessment. Collins sets and throws to Jordan, and that'll do it. The Miami Dolphins continue their regular season dominance against the Oakland Raiders. Six straight regular season victories.